Hey guys, it's Faye. In this two-part video, I'm going to show you how to set up automatic recurring payments using a combination of Zoom Webinar, PayPal turned on for Zoom, creating registration within Zoom Webinar, setting up Moonclerk, and finally connecting Zapier. Before I get started showing you how to connect Zoom and Moonclerk using Zapier, there are some prereq that you should be aware of. Number one, you need either the PayPal business or personal account. Number two, you need the Zoom webinar add-on. By the way, that is $40 a month. And thirdly, webinar scheduled with registration. So not only you need to set these things up, you actually need to create at least one registration for your webinar. In order for you to charge a recurring payment so that people can keep coming to your class, here's the thing. You need to configure Zoom webinar first with PayPal. So now to enable this is quite easy. So it's under account management, under webinar, and there's an option, as you can see right here, to allow you to charge a fee. Now you can do this with a single webinar or recurring webinars, okay? Quick clarification here. So in case you're worrying about that you're going to lose a two-way communication, you're not going to, because within Zoom webinar, you can easily switch between participants versus panelists or panelists back to participants. As a fitness instructor with so many students, the last thing you want to do is manually update payment options for each person. When your group is small, that's actually pretty easy to do. You could theoretically, you know, get 10 to 20 emails and then manually enter their credit card information or their payment information and turn that on as recurring. You can do this in your Squarespace website as well as using Stripe, which is a payment system, as well as PayPal. But you literally do have to do this manually. Now, what you're about to learn with Moonclerk and with Zoom webinar as an integration is that removes that manual process. So I hope that's clear. All right, now with that said, you need a plan with Zoom webinar. And once you do that, you will notice on the left-hand side under personal, all of a sudden you have this webinar options, right? Not only you have an option, you can actually begin to schedule webinars. There are training options if you need to see it. Now, in order to charge recurring fees, you need what? Recurring webinars. And look, it's exactly the same as how you're setting up a regular meeting. So I'm going to demonstrate that by saying my webinar description, when, 7 p.m. duration. Okay, now look at this. You need to say recurring webinars, and you can set the frequency. Is it daily? How often does it repeat? When does it end? You know, things like that. You can also obviously require people to register, and here that's a really good idea. You do need a registration page in order for people to sign up for this event. Keep in mind, you know, the prereq we talked about just now to enable the payment feature, you need webinar scheduled with registration. Okay, so now you're registered. I won't go on about all these options because I've done videos on YouTube and also available in Skillshare to kind of walk you through these options and how to make your meetings more secure. But now what you can do is click on schedule. Now you have created this recurring webinar. At the very bottom of the screen, what you can see is confirming your webinar size, because this is what we have paid for. Obviously, you can increase that number to 500 or more, I believe up to 10,000. One thing I didn't talk about is payment. Currently, this webinar is free if you leave it as is. Now, in order to make your webinar paid, what you need to do is go to the left-hand side of your Zoom account, under Account Management, select Webinar Settings. Now under Webinar Settings, I always have to search for this. Just search for the word fee or charge, right? You can see that registration setting right now, it says allow options to charge, fee not allowed. So you need to actually turn this on. Make sure you check this, and you need to connect this to a PayPal account. once you sign up for a Zoom webinar and you're able to create a registration page, now you're ready for Moonclerk. Moonclerk is a great tool for capturing recurring payments. Now, it also works seamlessly with Zoom webinars, and that's why I recommend this, because Zoom by itself doesn't come with a recurring payment method. Now, to take a look at Moonclerk's payment option, well, it's pretty flexible. If your monthly volume payment is under $2,000, your monthly price will be $15, and it increases from there. So once you sign up for Moonclerk, I do believe they have a free trial just to make sure you like it. When you arrive on Moonclerk, the first tab you see is called Payment Forms. Click on Forms. So to create a payment form, you simply give it a title. I'm going to call it Test. You can give it a description if you want to. You can choose the payment method, whether you want to accept only credit card and debit card, or you can also turn on bank account as well. Set specific amount. For example, for dance instructions, I can say that is $20. So now, instead of one time, you want to choose recurring. For most of you guys, I assume it's going to be monthly. Recurring day is the day the payer checks out. So I think this is quite convenient, because if you have an open enrollment for your dance classes, meaning somebody may sign up on the first of a given month, and the following week, maybe on the 7th, you have 3 more people sign up. So instead of charging people on the same date of the month, it actually makes sense for them to pay on the day that they choose to join your program. Lastly, the duration. The duration can be indefinite, so that people continue to pay, your program continues to run as long as people want to join your class. So for example, if you are running an academy, a business that requires a registration fee or new member sign-up fee, this is where you do it. You can capture additional information from payers, such as, you know, their address or their age or things like that. But these options are quite convenient, but you certainly don't need them all. You can display a message after the payer checks out. You can redirect them to a web page if you want to. You can include coupons, terms of service, so that you can include a document here. By the way, I'll also show you real quick how to give your customers or your audience the option to modify that, and they can actually log into Moonclerk and change their payment option if they need to. So by default, Moonclerk asks you, the admin, to kind of make all these changes. But here under account, what you'll notice is that Moonclerk will give the payer, meaning your customer, a portal, which is on this page, that there is a single portal link that you can use for your account. And then you can change the theme if you want to, and give the payer the option to cancel their plan, to update their names and emails and things like that. And also update plan frequency, for example. So once you make these changes, just click on save and you're all set. When someone needs to make changes, all you have to do is simply send them this portal link and they will be able to do all the rest on their own, hence eliminating your administrative effort. Now all that's done, you're ready to finally move on. Yes, that means you're ready to use Zapier to connect Zoom webinar recurring meetings and payments with Moonclerk. That means every time someone makes a recurring payment through Moonclerk, that person will be automatically registered under Zoom webinar. And that person will be able to receive things that you set up for Zoom to trigger, such as a confirmation email. They'll have all the registration information they need to begin classes. Instead of registering twice, they only need to do it once through the Moonclerk payment system. So let's take a look at how you could use the payment forms you just set up. Remember, this is a test I just did. Look, you have multiple integration methods. You can use integration to connect with different web services. Well, what I use most frequently is this. It's called Use. So once you click on that, you have options where you can send this direct link to people who want to register for your monthly classes. Look, you can copy this web address and paste it into an email, instant message, Facebook, Twitter, anywhere. You could also place this link on your website. You can just copy that. You can also embed this payment form on your website. You can place a button. So these are all the tools you can do directly
on Squarespace, for example, or if you have someone else manage your website, you can send this to your webmaster. So hope this helps.